Buddy, that's in the sport of bowling, and it's just going to be fantastic. I just saw Doug Blackler, the custom machine guy, throw his first ball. And Peter Flynn throw his first ball.
I'm going to tell you, Bobby, if Peter and Dougie both get going, you're going to see some real fantastic bowling with these two gentlemen right here.
I find myself sitting here just in amazement, okay?
Well, Doug Blackler starting over the nice spear in lane number 18, and Peter Flynn from the Mass team here with a nice strike here in his first frame.
Somebody's going to have to pinch me every once in a while to make sure that I'm here, Dougie. Like, I'm just sitting here and I'm totally amazed. I've been a bowler all my life, as you have been, but these guys are great and they hit them good. Blackler has a high single of 1.205, excuse me, and a high triple of 5.02, and an average of 1.30. Flynn, one of the great bowlers in the history of this sport, has an average of 130, a high single of 2.11, and a high triple of 4.82. And many times.
By five.
I'm really into paper reduction. At one point, I was getting two different phone bills. The two bills, it was very inconvenient, and it was just a little aggravating.
And then when I use AT&T, everything is right there. I only have to send my money one place.
One less to have to pay, one less check to have to write.
I switched back to AT&T, had the service that they're obviously known for.
I just wanted to have one bill and one check, and went back to AT&T, and they ran a special, come on back.
Wow!
So we did.
If you're getting two bills, come back for the convenience and service of AT&T. Call now.
From Lawrence, Mass. Is Jack Ray, who's had a phenomenal 220 string. And ladies and gentlemen, that is just really something. And a 470 triple.
Joe Ashline there, Bobby, started there. He's working on a strike right now. This is the second ball for the spear shot. Picks it up. Beautiful shot. Steve Webb with a big nine-pin break here in lane number 17. You played that one smart, Bobby. That wouldn't look too good to resist.
I'm going to remind Stevie Tuesday night in our league, we bowl on the same team. That, you know, we were always taught our whole life, if you can see the pin, play the pin. And I'm going to tell him, you know.
That
always
would look pretty good there, though.
Yeah, a great piece of wood.
Joe Ashline rolling on the mark. Big seven onto it. And he'll go to 15 over par after three frames. And Dougie come right back, or Stevie come right back there, Bob, and equal him with a seven on his.
Stevie had a little extra English on that one, didn't he, Dougie?
Oh, yes,
he knew he was
right
down the side, and he said, geez, I got to do something about this. So,
what do you think that shot of Joe Ashnine is now, Bobby, on lane number 18?
I think he's got to play the pin on the left. It's frozen there. I'm not saying he played it wrong, but I think if he would have got it, jammed it, it would have, the other pin would have
possibility,
kicked out the
Bobby, but with his speed and everything, I think it would have been at that front pin.
Could have been. The neat part is we were bowling in the tournament this weekend, Carl Jack, and I always ask if there's, where would you play? Because there's the right way and the wrong way.
Oh, yes, that's for sure. And that room's a lot of good scores, yep. A lot of this deadwood. So we get a pair of nines here, one from Gary and one from Steve Webb. Joe Ashline there is 54 after four completed frames. And we have Stephen Webb at 45 after four completed. Now lane number 18 here, we have Dave Richards from the Mass team. Lane 17, we have Barry Sauer here from Custom Machine and Tool. Good shot there for Dave Richards.
Nice spear. Got to take advantage of those opportunities,
Dougie. Yes.
This next game of candlepin bowling can really throw you for a loop from times you hit perfect and get nothing.
That's right.
And when you get that lucky break, you got to make sure that you make it pay. Nice eight for Barry Sauer.
Good eight.
It's always tough when you punch out the middle, just even psychologically. Either. Ladies and gentlemen, you're seeing some great hitting here, but you're watching the extra pins stay up constantly. And that's because it's early in the match. They're both tight. It's like two fighters sparring out there.
Big hit. Nice strike for Barry Sauer. Beautiful. Now, Dave had a good setup there, Bobby, but he had to get on the right-hand side of that number six pin because the wood was going right towards the seven for him.
And was frozen, and he almost had to miss that pin, didn't he?
That's
Ducky?
Right.
Like, just go by
it. Push it over. Beautiful strike there for Barry Sauer.
Before we get too far into the string, and while the next two bowlers are coming up, we've been very fortunate here at the Coca-Cola Classic. We have great sponsors, and we want to thank the Webby's Ball of Drum for providing the lanes and not charging for the bowling, which helps our prize fund. Coca-Cola, who have just been phenomenal over the 6 years of the tournament. Little Nashville and Bubba Hearn and Brenda up there, and great entertainment. A good spot. Big strike by Kelly.
That was a big strike, Bobby. McGlashan there for Bob Kelly on a spear.
So as he'll well be, as, sorry, Ducky.
He'll be 38 and open. Oh, fine shot there.
What a shot.
Beautiful.
What a shot. Sean O'Flaherty. Boy, how to answer the call there.
That was a
strike group. Looking at you. You pick out one, Ducky, and looking at a five or six box.
That's
with the
right.
Other guy throwing a strike.
Good 10.
Wonderful 10. In the old days, we used to say 10s were the key to the game, Ducky.
That's
and,
right.
And you can't get any better than punching out one, five, and eight and making a 10 out of it. No wood in the plate.
I've seen here so far, we've only had one box here, less than a 9. That was a 1-8 frame here, and I don't think we're going to see too many of them involving this entire match. Because all these fellas here are great pinners. Now, Bobby, that wood's froze on the number two pin there for Bob Kelly. Then he brings another wood up there. I think froze on the...
Frozen all the way. But I think he's got to go for the three, Ducky. He's got to get the count for the team. With the wood frozen, he might get 9.
A little bit dead on that shot.
Yep. Big 17 on the
Picked
strike.
Big 7 on it, though. Nice try there for Sean O'Flaherty, but very, very close to making that spear.
Just slid by. While Stephen Webb's going down clearing the wood, there's a line down there, ladies and gentlemen. Approximately one length of the pin out in front of the front pin. And any wood that's touching that line is called a dead wood, and it must be removed. So you'll see that happen from time to time. We also have a great friend in the sport of bowling and a really good bowler in his own right, and Gary Stewart, a Maritime Tell and Tell Cellular. And Gary is plugged into the sport and been a big help to us. Along with Jim Dent and Paul Forrester, the Colby Village Beverage Room, who invited the champs out for a steak and a beer the other night, and we all had a great time at the Colby Village Beverage Room. And Dartmouth's Kitties Inn, who put up with the world champions each year. And it's always wonderful because it's nice to be able to bring them in, have a nice place to stay. And last but not least, Ed Malloy at Discount Car Rentals gave us a nice 1993 Caravan to drive the world champs around. So, Ducky, that pays all our bills.
That's right, Paul. That's the main thing.
We'll get back to the bowling match.
Nice spear there for Graham Lassen, the custom machine and tool. And Gary Carrington of the MASH team picks up an 8. So Gary goes to 34 after 3, Bobby, 4 over. And Graham Lassen just picked up a nice spear there. And Graham will be 35 and open.
Tough leave. Steve Webb's going to get in shape here tonight, Ducky.
Yes, sir. I thought that one was all right. Didn't come up quite far enough.
Got to check, though.
So where's he going, Bubby? He going nose, going to try to split those two,
I think? I think there's a shot where you got to go for the 5-8, Ducky, and throw it over.
Big nine there for Graham Lassen, the custom machine and tool team. And a great setup there for another one for Graham Lassen.
You'd like to have a half a dozen of those every game, wouldn't you, Dougie? Wouldn't we be some good?
I'd even have 100 of them, Bob. Two nice shots there in a row for Graham Lassen.
The key is, and you'll watch these great bowlers up there, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to be a bowler, the number one factor is you got to hit that hit pin 8 times out of 10 to be a top flight bowler. And if you do, you're going to get 4 or 5 good chances and 2 or 3 what you consider non-chances. But the good bowlers are on the front pin, and that gives them the opportunity to make these great spears. You can often say that I could have made that shot, but could you hit the hit pin that good to set up that fantastic spear?
That's right.
Flynn's on the right. Great left-handed bowler. And Dougie Blackler's on the left.
All right, come on, get the sticks. Start coming.
Outside, Dougie.
Outside, yeah, but he's a little young, Bob, for playing him on the outside that far.
Only us old guys can play them on the outside to get them, right? Is that because it's desperation?
No, well, see, when you play them on the outside, you get 2 shots at the shot. Yeah. You miss it on the outside, then you got a chance getting on the inside.
Right on. Right on.
So, Bobby, so far in this match here, with 4 frames not even completed yet, we have 7 marks here for the MASH team and 8 marks for custom machine and tool. And we're just coming now to our final frame to complete 4 boxes per bowler.
They're approximately, Ducky, 39 over par for the world champs. Custom machine are 27 over par with 2 marks open. So you can call this one a dead heat.
That's pretty well.
What a shot. Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, you're going to see lots of that today. Phenomenal shot. See young Wade Black over there in the crowd. Dougie, one of these great young bowlers coming up.
Coming along great.
Beautiful ball.
Dougie's got a piece of wood here, Bobby, that could give him a little help here to take care of that 7 pin down the left-hand corner. Now he dropped that one just about on the foul line.
Dougie was just about ready to bowl and the light went off. That slows you down a little bit. Big nine for Doug Blackler. Hop on, baby. Hop on, baby. As well as the big money that these gentlemen are bowling for, they're bowling for the Coca-Cola Classic trophy. And the truly amazing thing about this, Dougie, is that in 6 years of Coca-Cola Classic, the world champs have never won here in Darwin, Nova Scotia.
Yeah, they've been in the finals, Bob, before over the 6 years, and they still haven't come through with a championship here in the Coca-Cola Classic yet. So we'll have to see what happens here today. So after 4 completed frames, Bob, we have Mass Team, Grandpa's Printing there at 39 pins over par, and we have Custom Machine and Tool at 26. And Custom has 2 marks to 1 for Grandpa's Printing.
Joe's a little frustrated. Just missed a 9-pin drop to 6-pin. I'd say that nearly got to be the perfect pin for him to shoot at.
Yeah, that's right.
Give a little rundown on the 9 teams who are in the Coca-Cola Classic. Woodside Bowlerama had a 12-42 record to be 9th. And Giuliano's Dining Room and Lounge with Ray Portello over there doing a great job. 16-38. Ashby Bideo, 3-time Coca-Cola Classic champs at 26-28. Elmwood Lantern, New Brunswick champs, 26-28. Dartmouth Bowlerdrome for 5th, 32-22. And Nick's Italian Village, 34-20 out of Sydney and Cape Breton Hydraulics, 38-16 to finish 3rd and 4th. Dougie, what just happened?
We had a Joe Ashliner picked up a very nice spear there, Bubby, for four pins on the left-hand side of the lane here. And Stephen Webb had a beautiful second ball. I don't know yet why the shot didn't go. He hit the 2, 7, and 6. He hit the two pin on the left-hand side, just flew right across, right past the six pin there. That would have given him a fantastic shot. Gary Sauer, lane number 8, is on a big strike here. His first ball, he leads up the 1, 2, 7, 9, and 10 with a piece of wood there, Bob. It's going to help him a lot if he can split the 1 and 2.
Oh, wow. What
a try.
Shot. Big 9.
And a nice tender for Barry Sauer. And also for Dave Richards.
So far this string, Duck, I think, and we finally called Don Vincent Ducky. We've been calling him that for 30 years. I don't know why, where he got the nickname, but when you hear me call Ducky, you know I'm talking about my partner, Ducky Vincent. Grandpa's pretty niv missed two what you call shots that they should make, a 9-pin break and an 8-pin break. And I don't think Custom has missed a chance yet. I'm talking about 8 or 9-pin breaks.
Yeah, that's right. Barry Sauer in lane number 18 with a 9-pin break, left the 10 standing. Dave Richards here with the 2 and the 10.
Wow. Just big spare by Barry Sauer.
He was just getting ready to drop off, but it just touched it. Good shot.
Yeah, it was just about to fall off the alley. That stayed right on the edge. Dave Richards seems to be getting the extra pin to go from Becker. Like in the shots that he's missed the hit pin so far.
Right.
His ball seems to be fairly alive. Like he had a nice break there off the hit pin. The last box and a couple boxes earlier, he had nice shots off of the front, missing the front pin.
So we're starting with the leadoff man, Joe Ashliner, after 6 completed frames. Joe's at 73 and open, and Dave Richards is 65. The leadoff man for Custom Machine is Tool. Steve Webb is 4 over at 64, and we have Barry Sauer at 71 and open after 6 completed frames.
Sean O'Flaherty on the right, and Bob Kelly on the left. Flaherty has a big 9-pin break. Beautiful hit pin hit.
Big strike there for Bob Kelly.
And Ducky, you know the last pin to fall for Bob Kelly was the 6-pin.
It was the 6-pin there.
Look what Sean
O'Flaherty
is up there, the 6-pin.
The 6-pin standing.
With two pieces that did would be around it, so you can call that identical hits.
Now that shot Sean just had there, Bobby. He hit that front wood and the ball bounced up and took that pin. There was another wood in behind that first wood there and didn't disturb it one little bit.
No, it just didn't come into play, but it's one of those shots that you could hit that deadwood just where you think it's perfect, and that ball could have missed the pin.
That's right.
So big shots by O'Flaherty and Kelly. O'Flaherty's working on a spear. Kelly's working on a strike. And it's a nip-and-tuck match, and we expect it to go right down to the last string, ladies and gentlemen. Truthful. Who says you can hit that pin and it won't fall over?
Yeah, we just seen that a couple times here. Steve Witt done the same thing in the first frame there. He touched it and it didn't go. Well, two pretty good breaks there for both these bowlers here for not being on the hit pin on their marks. Big spare there for Sean O'Flaherty.
Good hit by O'Flaherty.
There's a bad miss there for Bob Kelly.
That's a shot, though, Ducky. Traditionally, you've got to go on the outside.
Pretty well, Bobby. Right. Nice 9, though, for Bob Kelly out of that.
Graham Lassen. I believe Graham's working on a mark, and now Gary Carrington.
No, Gary's not on a mark, but Graham is, Bob.
Okay. Gary's one of the more colorful bowlers. In the sport of bowling, they say we need characters. And
that's right.
Funny guys and intense people, and Gary Carrington certainly is all of that, and a great bowler as well. A I think if that pin would have stayed up, Ducky, he would have had a better chance at the spear.
He had a better shot of making the spear. But he picks up 7 on his mark. And Graham goes to 61 after 4 completed frames. That's 21 over. Ah, good shot. Great spear there for Graham Lassen.
Oh, wow. Right on the money, Ducky. Just had to be an inch to the right, and you had a beautiful spear.
Good try for Gary. So now we have Graham Lassen, 71 on open after 5. 21 plus, Bob.
Great young bowler, Ducky.
Fantastic.
Very steady performer. Very seldom changes anything in the way he bowls. And of course, as you know, a great friend of mine, and it's just wonderful to see him still in the game. And he's only young, but compared to me and you.
Hey, speak for yourself, please. Big 9 on that one. Tell you one thing, Bobby, here, either one of these teams gets a good jump here. They still cannot declare them the winner. That last ball is thrown in that third string.
No question.
As Dave can't come back so fast, they can put a dozen marks together at one time.
Now, Gary got down too far on that, but...
That shot, Bobby, right.
Unofficially, I make that. That's 3 shots that the world champs have missed that were 9 or 8 been breaks.
Perfect setups.
Yeah. That's a better word, perfect setup.
And you can't miss too many of those, bowling against Custom Machine and Tool.
Yeah. Probably in the last 5 to 7 years, the greatest bowling team in Nova Scotia and the Maritimes, just a wonderful array of bowlers from the metro area here. And always in the money. Every tournament they're in, Ducky, they're just right there.
Peter Finn opened on a spitter, picked up a big hit onto it, leaves a 6 and a 10. Dougie's got the 4 horsemen plus the 8 pin.
Nice shot by Peter Flynn. Nice 8 pin break. This team really needed that, Ducky. The Custom Machine Tool are open 3 times.
And the Mass team are opening on 2, Bobby.
So they need to get somebody on a little bit of a roll to match Lassen. Lassen's going with 3 marks now. And Flynn should try to answer that for the world champs, Grandpa's printing for him.
That's right. Graham Lassen's gone up now, Bobby, to 90 and open after 6. Big strike there for Doug Blacker. That's twice Peter's done that same thing, Bobby, on the strikes there. Punched out the...
Yes, right through the center.
The
boy,
hit
that
pin
kills
there.
You don't care if you miss a hit pin, but you hate going through the guts. We call it punching out the guts.
So now we have 4 marks open there for Custom Machine and Tool.
Well, I do a little bit of a history on what happened this tournament, Ducky, and the next 2 guys are getting up. Why don't you do a little count over par and under par? And see,
I'll give you a little count here after 6 completed boxes, Bobby.
That'd be great. Had some fantastic performances this weekend at Webby's Bowl-O-Drum in the Coca-Cola Classic. Barry Soward was the high single award winner with 196. And Doug McDonald, Webby's Bowl-O-Drum, had a 195 and a 179 to be the 2nd and 3rd place in the high single. In the high double, Doug McDonald set a new Coca-Cola Classic record with a 359. The game he had 195, he had a 164. Peter Flynn had the 2nd and 3rd high doubles with a 307 and a 304.
Bobby, after 6 completed frames, we have our American friends here, the Mass team at 351, 51 pins over a pair. We have the Custom Machine and Tool at 357. Just a difference of 6 pins.
And Customs opened 4 times, and now Joe threw a punched out on that nice mark.
Oh,
Stevie Webb had a good opportunity there, Ducky. I think if he would have hit it up a little higher on the dib, we would have shot it right across.
Yeah, that's right.
Got that temping. However, he's there throwing the ball, and never underestimate the fact that you got to win or you want to win, and the desire is there, and sometimes you just don't get it where you want it to be, even as great as these people are.
If they can put the ball above every shot they want, it'll be nothing to the game. So this is, you're throwing the ball down there 60 feet. So right up to now, Bob, we're going to get 50. We're going to get 4 pins difference after six completed, or no, I shouldn't say six completed frames. We're coming down the top of the stretch here in the seventh and the eighth, but custom to 4 marks open. That still counts in the sixth frame.
Was some shot by Steve Webb, Ducky. It just goes to show you, in this sport of cattleman bowling, he was right dead bang on the pin, drove it through. There's a foot between those two pins down there, but it doesn't look it from the angles. And of course, the ball's only 4.5 inches, and the pin's 2.5 inches. So there's a lot of room to go through, and he picked out the front pin.
Yes, sir.
And the team high single and high double awards went to Custom Machine and Tool, who had a 728 high team single for five bowlers.
228 pins over time.
What a shot!
Beautiful shot there. Very solid.
And it went just like clockwork.
That's right, beautiful.
No doubt.
And Dave Richards picked up a nice 10 there. Well, Dave goes a 75 after seven completed frames. Barry Sauer was on him right there, Bob. Picked up 5 on it. Picked up that nice spear, beautiful spear, throwing a 3 over under the 2, and he'll go to 86 and open.
That extra pin isn't just quite going right now. Big 17 for Barry, Ducky. That's a nice count. He's looking at a chance for another spear. And here's an interesting one for Dave Richards of the World Champs.
I don't think he'll go for the wood. He is.
Wow.
Ooh, Brigger made it.
Beautiful try. Beautiful try.
Very, very close.
I know on Monday Night Football, once in a while, they talk about the game being over and this sort of thing, and it's very blasé, but this sport of cantlebin bowling, you know, the second and third string, there's 20 boxes for each bowler, and a lot can happen.
That's right. It can change so quick with a couple double strikes popping in, or Sanga gets hot and runs about 4 or 9-pin spears off in a row. Really changes it so quickly that you hardly realize it. Now, and Bob here. Kelly on lane number 18 there, and we have Sean O'Flaherty here on lane 17. Sean O'Flaherty open on a mark. And Sean is 72 and open after six. And Sean picks up a big 7 on his mark. Bob Kelly's got quite a split shot here. We just see one to made. Back there for Sean O'Flaherty. So Dave Richards, after 8 completed frames, he's up at 85, and Sean, or Barry Sauer, his opponent, at 102. 22 pins over for Barry Sauer after 8 completed frames. Sean O'Flaherty there, Bobby, just picked up a big 7 on his mark and made another one.
Coca-Cola record of 1380 for high doubles bowled by Grandpa's Printing this weekend, and they did it against no other than our team, Ducky's Julie's Dining Room and Lounge. And they had two strings to warm up, and they made the best use of it and came out firing all guns with a 703 and a 1380. So wonderful scores all the way around here.
Well, I think we broke a lot of records this weekend, the Skokola Classic. Yeah, we got a 13. What was your 1300 score there again?
1380.
And we had a 359 for two.
Those are two new.
And a 728, I believe, a team single.
You're right, Ducky.
Those are all new records.
All new records. Keeps getting better every year.
Well, there's a good seven there for Sean O'Flaherty over that.
Well, that's tough when you punch out one side, Ducky, then you say, well, I'm going to get it on the left side for the team and then go punch it out again.
Now, in our days, the bowling was Bud Baisley. We had that shot. We had to go for either corner, whatever corner you like the best, to go for a six. Now they go for the works.
For sure, because you know what? If you're a good bowler and you've missed a hit in two boxes in a row, what are the chances of you missing it again? You don't quite agree, Ducky, I can tell.
I think a six would look a lot better than a four.
Yeah. Lassen has seven on that, Ducky. It puts
and
him in.
Another nice setup, Bob. Oh, look at that shot there
heavens.
For Gary. That was beautiful. Beautiful try. This Mass team, Bobby, right now is having a little bit of tough luck here in a lot of their shots. I don't know what. They could come bursting back here on the second string here and
well, they
make
will,
the third
Ducky.
String really interesting.
They will, Ducky. This is almost like the NBA. They go back and forth and back and forth, and all of a sudden somebody just breaks loose.
Graham picked up a 10 there, Bobby, and he would have made that shot even where he hit that one there off of the pin. He was down at the bottom of the didwood.
Yeah, I think you could call that a miss, Ducky. The four pin, was it, or the two pin? Two pin.
Two pin.
Just drive it all. The woods were all set up there for him.
But you just can't get them all. Spare there for Gary Carrington. They went to a few boxes there, but we're going to mark the Mass team there. And
I think it adds up to 11, Ducky. And
11 boxes out of mark. That's very unusual for this team.
First and third high averages in the Coca-Cola were by Peter Flynn and Bob Kelly, who had 134.3 and 130.2, respectively. Great shot there by Graham. It looks like I didn't see the shot. Duck, was it?
Well, he had the...
lucky, was it?
He had the four and the six. There was wood on the four, double wood. He smashed that, then the ball come back and took the six pin for him.
Be nice to throw that hard, wouldn't it, to have a ball come back in the alley? Dougie McDonald was second in the averages with 131.8. Dougie just had a tremendous tournament.
I'd like to give congratulations to John Nichols from... the piece of place in Sydney there. Bobby rolled 128 this tournament. That's very good.
Yes, wonderful bowler, nice guy.
Dougie Blackler working on a strike here. He has an 8-pin break. And picks up the spare onto it. And a big 9 for Peter Flynn. Right now we have 12 marks, Bobby, for the Mass team there from the Boston area. And 18 marks for Custom Machine and Tool.
It's a 49 pin difference right now, Duck, for Custom Machine and Tool.
Over the Mass team.
Over the Mass team.
Not enough.
Oh no, a long ways. Long ways away. Well, we're going down the 9th and 10th, Ducky, and I think it's not important for the world champs, Grandpa's Printing from Lawrence, Mass, to to win this string, but to get their balls working for the second and third one.
That's
have a
right.
little fun.
Cut this one and down as much as they can. Right now, I think they're down 50 pins there. Peter had a 9, and Dougie finished up with a 10.
That would make it 50.
50 pins down.
I heard Joe Ashline say, hey, we're down 50. We can't do any worse than this. Let's
but
get
I
it
was
going.
Talking to the captain of the mass team there, Jack Ray, just before this match started. They were down 75 pins in the last match they rolled today. After 8 frames, they had 4 open marks, and they only lost a string by 7 pins.
Yes, that was against Cape Breton Hydraulics.
That's
and
right.
Harold McDonald, the captain there, told me, said, you wouldn't have believed it. He said, we had them.
Nice spare there for Steve Webb.
Harold said to me, Bob, we had them hammered 75 up after 8. Would you believe it? He said they came back and beat us by 67 over the next
2 frames.
Two
lost
frames.
The string by 7
That's
pins.
That's only 10 boxes. 2 per bowler. He said it was down, all of a sudden it's down to 7 pins. It was just remarkable.
So now we have Custom Machine and Tool up at 52 pins and
open twice.
Open twice. And we have the mass team open with 1. Picks up 4 on it.
Wow.
Big strike there for Joe Ashline, leadoff man for the mass team.
I think that poor number 10 pin Ducky had 2 deadwoods rolling against it. He was going to say, I'm going. I'm not going to get bowled over. That was a given. The pins were flying over at it. Big strike by Ashline. This could be the start of something a little exciting. Webb got 4 on the mark.
7 in the frame, that cuts the lead down now to 53. And I believe they still have 2 open marks for each team here, Bob.
Just not quite on it. You know, like everybody's missing their front pin on the key mark except Lassen. Lassen's had 6 marks out of the 8 boxes. And
take a bite, baby.
Big Joe Ashline ball here on a big strike.
16.
So 6 on it cuts them down to 47 now, Bob. It was 50 here when they started the last 2 frames. So Joe Ashline, leadoff man for the mass team, finishes up with 116. Beating Stevie Webb of Custom Machine and Tool by 11 pins. Steve finished with 105. Kind of helpful. Barry shot there, night number 18, Bobby, around the rib band or to the right?
I would say a little to the left of the rib band to try to shove it, the backwood over on the 10. He didn't get enough to push it straight back.
That's right, got it on the end. And a big mark there for Dave Richards of the mass team.
I know he had a lot of deadwood to work with, Ducky, but it's just what's happening in this whole match now. David hit that deadwood on the nose when he had a whole deadwood in front of the pin. And I think that, you know, that he was playing with danger there.
Well,
he barely missed it.
With the fast ball he has, Bobby, this can happen if you hit him on the end. He'll jump right up and over.
Yep. Barry's down the
side. One of our grandpa balls like you and I throw, you know, I might have made that shot. We don't have the speed to lift them. Now, there's one that tell your mother about. Look at this, the 1-3 on Dave Richards. Spear he just had there.
Earlier, Sean O'Flaherty, what did he have, the 8 out of that?
No, Sean had the 1, 3, and 6. Oh, good try there for Barry. Look at that pin still wiggling at him. He's got it.
What a shot! What a shot! Holy mackerel! Fantastic. Another Alcoa fantastic finish, huh? Fabulous.
Big 10 for Barry Sauer. Great try there by Dave Richards in that second ball.
Wasn't that something right in the wheelhouse there?
Beautiful shot. So we're after 2 completed bowlers here above. We have 222 for the mass team. We'll have to wait till our young, good-looking young lady over there, scorekeeper.
Maureen Beeler.
And the custom machine and tool are 226. There's just 4-pin difference after the first two bowlers. Well, these bowlers are just having two rougher breaks there in this first string.
That did what was sitting in there half decent, Ducky. Now it's moved away. I don't think that'll go off the deadwood, Ducky. It rolled out from behind.
From behind it, but if he gets down there far enough onto it.
Yes, sir.
Okay, when he got down far enough, he springed the bottom part up to the worst, that number two pin.
Well, it did that. Have you heard that worm turn before, Ducky? Some of my sayings are making it all the way to the States.
And right now we have a tie game here between Sean O'Flaherty there on lane number 18 for custom and Bob Kelly here, the MASH team. But Bob has one advantage. He's open on a mark. Picked up a real nice spear there.
Of course, I heard from the United States, Ducky, about the... I heard them fellas from down in USA say how to answer the call, and certainly Sean O'Flaherty answered the call with a big 9-pin break with Didwood. He covers. Kelly had 9 on the mark, and another one. So they must be just about dead even, aren't they, Ducky?
No, Bob hit 9 in that spear of his, Bobby. That put him 9 up on Sean. They were tied. They both got 9-pin breaks. Both speared him up. So Bob Kelly's at 126 and open, one ball left, and we have Sean at 117 and open with one ball left. Well, Bob can't gain too many on Bob with that big 9 on his.
He can only get a strike. He doesn't.
So Bob Kelly finished up with 129. And we had Sean O'Flaherty at 126, I believe, Bob. Yeah, 126 for Sean O'Flaherty. Graham Lass in lane 18 there, and Gary Carrington from the MASH team here in lane 17. And I got to say, Bobby, that Graham Lass is right on the hit pin. Oh, nice big strike there. So after 3 completed bowlers, Bobby, in the first string, we only have 1-pin difference for custom over the MASH team.
What a shot.
What a shot there. Look at the marks.
Don't you love to hear all the people clapping and shouting behind there, Ducky? It's just fabulous. And some great bowling here.
Graham last 133 in the open after 9 on a mark. And we have Gary Carrington at 101 open on a big strike here. The only difference in this game right now, boys, is between Graham and Gary here for the difference in the score. Well, now, I don't know about that.
Remember I told you that they got one character on their team called Gary Carrington, the Babe. And there he comes through with a double bubble. I'll tell you, big hit.
And he was on a mark in the end. Oh, good shot there for Graham Lassen. So Graham goes 151 in open. We have Gary Carrington at 91, 101, 11, 121 in open.
Fabulous, isn't it, Ducky? This is just exciting, ladies and gentlemen, to be here as a bowler and be fortunate enough to be sitting here bringing you this coverage of the Coca-Cola Classic. Fabulous bowling, great talented athletes out there in their own right. And Graham Lassen, I just believe it, a 166.
Bobby, you were 10 pins out there with Graham at 156. 156, Bob. Gary Carrington with a big triple strike there.
Well, we've never seen that on this match yet, Ducky.
Kerrigan, when he went up in this attack, these last two frames, he was 11 over at 91 after 8. Gray was 123. That's 43 over. And Gary is going to beat that 156.
Well, he needs... No, he can't.
Yes, he can.
He can have 151.
You're right, Bob. What a finish. That's what I'm saying. You'll never know here.
Fabulous. The big difference in this whole game, as you just put it out, Ducky, was that Graham really was hammering Gary Carrington. Well, Gary Carrington turned that around
in
short, sweet style. And now
we're going to the scoreboard, Bob, I imagine, after Peter and Doug get finished here. So after four completed bowlers, this first match here, we have the Mass team at 500 even after four. We have Custom Machine and Tool at 508, just 8 pins in the difference.
I can't hear. I just need hand signals,
Bad miss there for Peter Flynn. But they cut that big lead, Bobby, of 50 pins from the end of the eighth down here to around 13 pins, I think the difference is now.
And Peter had the 6 to Dougie's 10, so probably it's 17 pins right now.
Or approximately around 16 or 17 pins.
But we promised you action, and action you're seeing. You know, Don, Ducky Vincent, I don't think I've ever seen Peter Flynn have a 6 box. I can't ever remember him missing a pin on the last ball.
Especially when there's 3 together, he went right by them. Let's see, the only trouble with Peter now, if Peter come back next time, give you 190 strength. He just makes one little adjustment, makes all the difference in the world.
Yes, change the tape.
Come back, boys.
Just tell him to give me the signal. I can't hear.
No.
Put it right up. I can hear.
Can you hear him now?
Going to the scoreboard.
Now, Bobby, we're going to go to the scoreboard here. We'll run them down.
Take a quick run down here, Ducky, but what we've seen is the 624 by Custom Machine and Tool in the first string to Grandpa Lane's with 608. So an exciting finish. Gary Carrington, the story of the match, coming back in Graham Lassen. Lassen in a 156, but Carrington with a spear, triple strike, and 28 on it, brought his team right back into the hunt with 149. So that's how it stands here at the Coca-Cola Classic. I'm Bob McGlashan. I'm with Ducky Vincent, and we'll see you in the second string. Welcome to the 1993 Coca-Cola Classic. My name is Bob McGlash, and I'm here with Ducky Vincent at Webby's Bolodrome with Grandpa Lane's 1992 World Champs versus Custom Machine and Tool from Mount Uniac, Nova Scotia. We had a very exciting first string with Custom Machine and Tool leading with 624, forgive me, and the World Champs are at 608. But the real story of the match was how Graham Lassen had a big jump on Gary Carrington, Duck, and
that's
came
right,
back
Bob.
To nearly equalize the match.
That's right. Graham finished with 156. 6, I believe, was it? And Gary with the 149.
And the story was, Gary Carrington was open on a spear in the 8th. He threw a double strike with 8 on it to come up to the 149 and nearly equalize this whole match. So now we had a 50-pin lead by Custom Machine and Tool after 8 boxes.
After
and now
8 boxes
down
is the
to,
first show, is right.
16 pins. So we have a very exciting string coming up for you between the World Champs and Custom Machine Tool, who were the 1988 and 1992 Coca-Cola Classic Champions. So we're going to go right to the action, Ducky, and I'm sure we'll see some more great bowling.
Yes, sir. We can almost guarantee that, Bob.
Okay, thanks very much, and we're going to go right to the action. No change in the lineups, Ducky. Steve Webb for Custom Machine and Tool on the left, and Joe Ashline for the World Champs, Grandpa Printing on the right.
On the right. Be very nice, Bob, to see the second string go down to about 5 pins or so, then really have a real battle on for the third. Joe Ashline, lane number 18 there for the Mass team from Boston with a big 9-pin break. Steve Webb here on lane 17 with Custom Machine and Tool with an 8-pin break. So Custom Machine and Tool picks up the 1 and 2 pin there to lead off himself with a big mark here and a nice tender for Joe Ashline of the Mass team.
I think in the last string, Ducky, that in real spear chances that we watched 8 or 9 pin breaks, no crazy Didwood or a 3 down the line. I think that's the way Joe started the first string, was a strike in the second box.
That's right. Steve Webb with a big strike on his. 3 marks out of 4 boxes. This should be a very exciting one here, Bob, coming up.
Oh, it's just fabulous. Just fabulous.
Now we
you
have
gotta
Dave,
love it.
Dave Richards on lane number 18 for the Mass team, and Barry Sauer here on lane 17 for Custom Machine and Tool. Where's...
Funny when you miss a shot, how quiet it gets in this place.
Yeah, that's right. And Custom, 3 marks, 3 boxes, 3 marks.
We got some great totals for these young men up here bowling. And very quickly, Stephen Webb has a high single of 202 and 506. Stevie just finished. And his counterpart, Joe Ashline, has a high single of 203 and a high triple of 505. Dave Richards has a high single of 191 and a high triple of 468. And Barry Sauer, who you're going to see throw the next ball, has a high single of 199 and a high triple of 465.
Great setup there for Dave Richards. Bob in lane number 18. Anywhere's on that 3 and 6 pin should give him that shot with his Didwood in the back there.
Robbed.
I don't think he could hit any better.
Beautiful shot.
Barry Sauer picks up 7 on his mark. Well, good effort there for Barry Sauer. Almost got that one, Bob, I think.
Tough
just a little more down lefty. Might have spun that over for him.
Barry's shooting at the 10-pin here for a 10 box. And he's... goes in the ditch a little early, ends up with a 9.
Bobby, do we still have our scores handy there from the first round? No, I think they're underneath your papers there somewhere. Here we go. Just to let some new listeners know that maybe didn't see our first show here, we had...
big strike by Bob Kelly. Ducky, I'll keep them tuned in to what's going on the lanes. Kelly just throws a strike. Beautiful pocket hit, and Sean O'Flaherty's up now.
Strike, first strike.
Fantastic.
I'm just going to give the audience, Bobby, the scores from last week. Custom Machine and Tool with their first string. Steve Webb at 105, Barry Sauer with 121, Sean O'Flaherty with 126, Graham Lassen with a beautiful 156, and Doug Blackler finishing off for the anchor's position with a 116 for a 624. Now we come down to Grandpa's Printing there, the team from Boston. Joe Ashline, leadoff man with 116. We have Dave Richards at 106. Bob Kelly at 129. Gary Carrington at 149. And Peter Flynn with a 108 for a total of 608. Giving Custom Machine and Tool a 16-pin lead going into our second round.
And of course, this is a three-string match. And the winner after three strings is determined on total pinfall. They're bowling for nearly $4,000 between the two teams, first and second. And it's total pinfall all the way. We had such an exciting tournament this weekend. Everybody going into the final string of the whole tournament. There were three teams tied with first place. And a number of other ones had chances, just depending on how the first three teams split their points. But Grandpa Printing came through with a big 6-0 win. And Custom Machine and Tool and Cape Breton Hydraulics, who were tied for first going in the last one, slipped down to third. But very, very tight bowling all the way along the line. Sean O'Flaherty, who just rolled, was a 197 high single and an outstanding 458 triple. And Bob Kelly has a big 210 single and a 481 triple. Just saw Gary Carrington, who really came back at Graham Lassen in that first string. He has a 195 single and a 480 triple.
Gary Carrington, I lane number 18, starts up with a big mark there, and I presume Graham Lassen will pick this one up. These two fellows are having quite a battle, Bob.
Wow, it's just been thrilling, the way one throws one mark and the other comes right back. And it's always a little exciting when your partner throws a, or your opponent throws a great shot, and then you're standing up there to bowl, and you know that he's got that spirit. It always sometimes takes a little off your own ball. Carrington got a little lucky there.
He got a little lucky there, he got, but it's still a nice eight on to it. Carrington goes right back with an eight on his. There was only seven pins, Bobby, separating these two in our first string of the roll-off here.
And their scores were outstanding, 156 to 149. So.
Gary and Carrington picks up his spear in the second frame, and so does Graham.
Fabulous.
Now we're going to have Peter Flynn here coming up in lane number 18, and Doug Blackler here in lane 17 for Custom.
Graham
Lassen. Bobby, order the Custom's first eight boxes, they got five marks. And the Mass team has four.
Looks so like six marks for Custom Machine and Tool.
Six marks for Custom Machine Tool over the first eight.
Only two open boxes. Come on. Graham Lassen, who had 156 the first ring and opened up with two marks this game, has a high single of 194 and a high triple of 468. Peter Flynn, one of the great bowlers in all of candlepin bowling, has a 211 single and a 482 high triple. And Doug Blackler has a 205 and a 502 triple. Dougie just hit that shot. Beautiful, Doug.
Beautiful. I don't know yet, but kept it up.
That happens. And that's the sport of candlepin bowling, which we all love, but it can bring you right to your knees. Candlepin bowling is one of those beautiful things. Girls can be guys, kids can be parents, and little guys can be big guys. And it's a great sport. Wow. A lot of stuff on the ball there.
Oh, them balls are just fabulous with the amount of gear on them, Bobby. There's a game of candlepin bowling. Dougie's right on the hit pin, cuts through three over the middle, and Peter was down the side, comes up with a nice nine-pin break with a big wood with it.
Look where that dead one came, Dougie, halfway up the bowling alley. See, now all of a sudden this game turns right back around again because the world champs, Grandpa Printing, have five marks and Custom Machine and Tool have six. So there's only one mark difference and the six box adds up heavy because that's four big pins. the two alternates on these two squads who are not seen in action here. Both these teams don't change their lineups too much, but
we haven't seen them as yet, Bobby, but there's a possibility we can see them.
Because Chris was warming up, and so was, well, I didn't see Jack warm up, but Chris Pomerenzi from the Valley is a 192 single and a 480 triple. And Jack Ray from the Boston area has a phenomenal 220 triple, single, I should say, and a 470 triple.
Steve Webb here is open on a strike here. And there's a double strike there for Joe Ashline.
Well, we've had a double strike, a triple strike. In fact, it's only the first 12 boxes of the match.
We could see a four here, Bobby. Steve Webb picks up 9 on his strike, 10 in the box. Joe Ashline picked up another strike here to give him a double. You know, that very first frame here that Joe hit here, Bobby, in his first box of the second string here, he had a beautiful 9-pin break. That also could have been a strike. So he could have had 3 in a row.
Could have 3 in a row already. Big time bowling, Ducky. Big time bowling. That wood just went off the plate.
Just went off the plate on Steve.
Joe really gets into the game, eh?
Come back into play. Come back. Oh, come on back.
Now, Candle have been bowling. Each ball's worth 10, or each box is 10. So, like, he had a strike. He had a double strike. That's 20 plus the 8 count, so it gives him 28. There's a lot of chatter on this shot here, Ducky, but I think he can only get it by hitting that deadwood on the left and the ball bouncing back off the wall. I think he's going to hit that deadwood on the left. Of course, he throws so hard he hit the one back and really bounced.
Stevie had a nice 9-pin break there. Bobby would have had a bad piece of wood.
Tough wood.
He had to get it very, I'd say, right out in the very end. Then that wouldn't say he'd still get it. It was that tricky a shot. So Joe Ashline, after 4 completed frames, is 27 pins over a pair, Bob, at 67. Steve Webb, very close behind him at 59 after 4, 19 pins.
Barry Sourd on the right, Dave Richards on the left.
And a big 9-pin break here for Dave Richards of the Mass team. Got a good guy going in there for it.
It's amazing about turning points, but how this whole thing turned around with Gary's triple strike, Ducky.
That's right.
I mean, it should turn the game around. Let's face it, he's on a mark, throws a triple strike with 8. But it's just, the customer up 50 pins.
50 pins at the end of 8th, and they come back and only lost by 16.
Just amazing. We have a lot of wonderful help putting on this Coca-Cola Classic. This weekend, we just had Frank White hit of Coca-Cola here, and Coke put a big amount of cash and give us pop and lots of prizes for the bowlers. It's wonderful to have such great support from Coca-Cola. Big 9-pin break. One of these times, Dave or Joe is going to jump right into our little area here, Ducky.
He's got a nice frozen wood there on that pin there. Very sour shot, Bobby. What do you think about that? The end of that wood on the right?
Right on the right
and the
hand.
Pin.
Try to put it right in between the tip of the deadwood and the pin. Wow.
What a try. And a nice spare there for Dave Richards. Dave goes to 46 and open after 4. I don't think that would have been any good, Bobby. That's third ball of Barry's there to play that wood on us for a spear shot.
No, I think if you would have just nicked the end, like
nicked the
go
end,
through
yeah.
the hole and hope it kisses off each other, that would have been it.
So now we have 8 marks for the Mass team, and we have 2, 4, 6 for Custom Machine and Tool.
And it's important now for Custom Machine and Tool to start in again. Kelly.
Another big strike there for Bob Kelly.
Right, You guys can hear, you television viewers can hear Gary Carrington in the back. It's big stuff. You see how it turns around, Dougie?
Yes, sir.
Boom. John O'Flaherty couldn't hit that shot any better.
That's right.
Pins jumped all around that 10 pin and it didn't go. And that's bowling. But I love that word in the NFL called momentum. It looks like Mo is with the world champs right now. Had a lot of other sponsors for the Coca-Cola Classic. I'll just take a quick rundown, but no more importantly than any other is Bolodrome, who have been a great supporter of this tournament over the last 5 years. This is their sixth year. Little Nashville, Country and Western Cabaret, Bubba Hearn and Brent up there, always been big supporters of the sport of bowling. MT&T Cellular, we got a great friend in Gary Stewart and a good bowler in his own right. Colby Village Beverage Room, Paul and Jim out there and have had the world champs out there for 2 years in a row for steak and a beer. And we all hung around, played some pool, and they're great friends of our Coca-Cola Classic. Keddie's Dartmouth Inn and Eileen at Keddie's have provided accommodations for the world champs for 2 years in a row now, and we really need them, as well as Ed Malloy's Discount Car Rental. Eddie's provided us with a beautiful caravan to drive the world champs around beautiful downtown Dartmouth and back and forth from Keddie's to the Webby's Bowlodrome for the weekend. So we've had a lot of great help from a lot of good sponsors, Ducky.
Bobby, while you were talking to her, that was a bad misser for Sean O'Flaherty with that four pin up with a big plank across it and just got to the outside of it.
I saw,
you know,
that
a shot like that could take a young fellow like Sean and take him down a little bit.
Great point. You just took the words right out of my mouth, because that's got to make him shake a little
bit. That's right. Let's hope it doesn't happen to him, but it's it was a bad miss on his part.
Last is seven on his mark after two in a row. Gary Carrington, eight on his.
Gary goes a 36 after two, 16 over. And we have Graham Lassen, I'm sorry, at 17 over.
Both of them miss. It's funny how you get going in a battle, right? One misses and the other misses.
That's right.
That's what you, I think, a little bit called respect, because, you know, you almost feel for the guy you're bowling against is missing. You say, okay, now I can get one on him. You maybe try a little harder, and then, boom, you miss too.
That's true. They both picked up nice tens there. Right now we have the Mass team up three marks more. They have nine, Custom Machine Tool with six.
The customer going through a little drought, just like the world champs did, Ducky.
They're in the first string, they're on their third or fourth and fifth box.
I think what did we count up? Grandpa's Brinny went with 11 boxes without a mark.
11 boxes without a mark.
And now customer at 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 without a mark. And of course, Graham's not going to throw a mark in this one, so 10. So
they hit a dry spell there without
no
marks.
They've hit a dry spell.
10 in a row.
Tough shot by Carrington. He's got to get a hold of that pin that's there, the two pin.
Good 10. Nice 10. Great 10 there for Graham Lassen.
Nice 10 out of that mess, as we say in the bowling business. It's wasn't very prosperous looking first ball when you punch out the guts, but when you get that 10. Other notable action here in the Coca-Cola Classic at Webby's Bowlodrome this weekend. I'll give you a rundown of the teams. Of course, you're seeing Custom Machine and Tool and Grandpa's Printing, who are 1-2 with records of 44 and 10 and 42 and 12, respectively. Cape Breton Hydraulics were 38 and 16. Nick's Italian Village was 34 and 20. Webby's Bowlodrome was 32 and 22. Elmwood Lantern, New Brunswick champs, were 26 and 28. Ashby Video, 26 and 28. Giuliano's Dining Room and Lounge, a nice spot over in Halifax, in the Fairview area, 16 and 38. And Woodside Bowlerama were 12 and 42. Make it! the 11th box, Doug Blackler gets the mark before his team went 11. So it stops the bleeding, as they say, a little bit. And maybe get custom machine and tool thrown a few marks again.
It's a good way for Doug to come back, Bobby, after he had that sixth frame there in the second box and back with a spear in the third. That builds up confidence.
Good bowlers don't stay bad long. I think Peter is just really struggling right now. He had 108 the first string, but when a guy averages 134, you know, for a whole tournament, that's 26 pins lower than what it should be.
You just watched this shot of Peter Finn's right here now. He's so sharp on that seven pin.
Yeah, it's like
he's got a wood right alongside of Bobby and another one there. I think if he hits a seven thin, that he's going to get that shot. It's got to shoot across, I think.
And a little bit of a Didwood sticky note there, ducked down on lane 18 for Doug Blackler. So,
and we had a little runner there, Jack Gray, the captain of the Massachusetts team.
They affectionately, Steve Webb asked him, listen, tell us how to play that shot when you get down there and have a look at it. But now that Didwood's quite far out, isn't it?
Didwood's just about out the front of the plate, Bobby.
So I think you got to go down the left-hand tip, don't
left
you?
Left-hand and to push it towards it. Wow, 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 that was a gift.
I didn't see that did. I guess we're just all assuming that he was worried about the front Didwood.
That's right.
And he had wood around the two and the four pin. That was a tough leave for Peter Flynn, the 7 and 10.
7 and 10, but I think if Peter had got on that seven pin, Bob, that would have shot right across.
Yeah, like if his ball just would have went off to nearly go off.
Nearly
the plate,
go off
like,
the lane and hit it.
Yeah. Some great team totals this weekend. Ducky, Custom Machine and Tour, high singles team with 728, a new record. Grandpa's Printing was 1380, a new record for the Coca-Cola Classic. And other noteworthy items, Grandpa's Printing at a 703 as well.
And Bobby, right now, after four completed frames here, with the exception of a spare frames team, we have the Mass team at 60 pins over par, Custom Machine and Tool at 32. So there's a difference there right now at 28 pins, and they're both open once.
So they got a little jump. Webb's got a nice 8-pin break here, Duck. Good Didwood on it. I don't think there should be any problem here. He hits it for on the red band or above.
And a big spare there for Steve Webb.
Good shot.
Joe looks like he got to pick a fence down there.
It's almost a little the difference between the American guys and our guys. Like somebody said, they don't want any more eights. I think that's important to recognize that they consider an eight a bad box.
Well, I go right along with them, Bobby. And I think an eight is a very bad box in bowling.
Big eight count by Steve Webb, which would put his team up to 40 over par.
Good shot.
Joe Ashline, nice mark.
Big shot there for Joe Ashline.
We had some fabulous high singles and high triples today. And I just want to mention a couple. Barry Sauer led the way with a 195 of Custom Machine Tool. You're watching Barry bowl here in the final. And Doug McDonald hit a 195. We had a new Coca-Cola Classic doubles record set this weekend by Doug McDonald with the 359. Right after the 195, he came out with a phenomenal 164. Peter Flynn had a 307 and 304 for two string doubles. Flynn also won the averages with 134.3, just 0.2 of a point shy of Steve Webb's classic record of 134.5. Doug McDonald hit a 131.8 to finish second, and Bobby Kelly and a 130.2.
Dave Richards, lane number 18, open on a mark, puts up five on it. Barry Sauer here in lane 17. 45 after 4-5 over par. Well, there's a couple great shots here, Bobby, for both of them. Dave, just a little thin on his.
Just a little thin. But boy, with the kicker, the Didwood in the back there.
And Barry Sauer picks up his mark.
It's like two great basketball teams. One makes a little run, the other team seems to cool off.
Yeah, that's
right. The other team's making a run, going back and forth here at Webby's Bowling Room in the 1993 Coca-Cola Classic. We have the world champs from Lawrence, Mass., two-time Coca-Cola champions, Custom Machine and Tool, who won the original tournament in 1988 and were last year's champion, defeating Webby's Bowling Room in the final.
There was a tough one, one on the mark.
Oh, nothing worse. Nothing worse, one on the mark.
Especially when his opponent gets and picks up a spear on him.
And the amazing thing, in 6 years we've had the tournament, this is our sixth year, that the world champs have never won this tournament.
They haven't won it yet, Bobby, no.
And they've been in four finals, New Hampshire All-Stars and Alfies, both from the south of the border, didn't even make it to the final.
That's right.
So it's just been it's been one of those things. I think the boys enjoy themselves, and they have fun while they get up here, and they're treated like world champs, which they deserve. But when it comes to bowling, we're always felt proud that we were as good as anybody. And it just goes to show that.
One of our biggest disappointments was 3 years ago here when Tommy Olster was with the world champs. He rolled the high average for the tournament, went in and rolled a three-string total of 303. It was almost hard to believe, but that's bowling, and that stuff happens.
And he had 130 average for the whole weekend.
130 for the whole weekend, and finished up with a 303 in the finals.
And that relates to a 390 for every time he bowls three strings. That's interesting, Ducky. You had mentioned earlier about Sean Flaherty. What do you think's happening up there now? He missed a gimme.
Well, he could be, as I say, Bobby, that gimme he missed, that could tighten him up a bit. Because when you get something going for you, like Sean had going there, I missed a pin with a great big stick in front of it. That's got to take a little earlier.
It'll be exciting for him the next time he gets a shot that could be. If that would have gone down, this is a test. This is a test for the young man. That's a shot he should make.
He
did it a long way. Kelly's got his mark on the board.
You just notice the red band here, Bobby, just in case he hits it on the red band. See? Every time that red band is hit on the red band, it'll spin that pin.
That
spins it around instead of going through.
It's amazing, isn't it? You look at that shot and it's... How
you
can
you think
not
it's
go?
A goner.
That wasn't as easy as it looked, ladies and gentlemen. I know that from the camera angle, so it's a big nine-pin break with a Didwood out front, but it was at a crazy angle, and just at the angle that when you hit the Didwood, drives the Didwood into the gutter, and the ball's of no use to you there. But he picks up a nice 10.
But either end of that shot for Sean there, I think, would have taken above either end of the wood, right directly at it or down the other end. So now we have the MASS team here with their three men coming down to sixth frame, all open. So they have three open marks now, the Customs one. Gary Carrington, lane 18, Graham Lassie here in lane 17. Great try there for Gary Carrington. Split the one and three. Graham Lassen with the number four pin, picks it up for a nice spare.
That's always nice when you get a nine-pin break, Ducky, and you just go down and hammer it. It really does a lot. I always called the nine-pin break singles like a confidence builder. Just always felt great about it.
Well, we just had the case there with Sean, you know, two of them.
Two 9-pin breaks with Didwood.
That's right.
It's got to make you really worry.
Graham Lassen, lane 17, open here on a big mark. Gary Carrington, lane number 18, with a 7-pin break.
Oh, through the guts.
Graham Lassen picks up 3 on his mark. Good try there for Gary Carrington. I'll have to check and see if he's 50 yet, Bob. He played that one on the outside and didn't get it. There's a nice big 10 there for Gary Carrington for the Mass team. And Graham gets 3 on his mark, 7 in the box. And Gary Carrington goes to 75 after 6, 15 over. And we have Graham Lassen at 75. The two boys are tied, Bob. They're having quite a battle here between the two of them.
And 156 to 149 for Lassen in the first string.
In the first string.
So already, Lassen's 61 over par for 16 boxes.
Right. Peter Flynn, lane number 18.
I'm sorry, Ducky, 71.
71.
71 pins over par.
Doug Blackler here in lane number 17. You know, the way Peter's going right now, Bobby, almost reminds me of the Tom Yosemite we were just talking about here 3 years back. Peter with 108 in his first string there. That's not the Peter Flynn we know.
No, sir.
And he's only over 1 over par right now at the end of 4 at 41.
Good
Dougie,
try.
Dougie was on a mark there, Bobby, at the time. He just got the 7 on it and very, very close to another one.
On those shots, you have to split the two pins very light, throw it across.
Oh, Peter Flynn finishes up with an 8, Doug Blackler with a big 9. Peter goes to 49, Bobby after 5, 1 under.
They call him the Sheen. It's a remarkable story how he had big-time brain surgery 3 years ago. Did very well, came through it fine. And Galeed Grandpa's bringing back to the world title. They had, I don't think it was without consequence that... What a shot.
I see things just aren't going for him. Dougie was very close in that shot, I'll tell you. Big 10 there for Peter Flynn, and a big 9 here for Doug Blackler.
It seems to me that, remember in the first string I told you that Grandpa's printing, we're missing more spears than Custom Machine Tool. Now I think this string,
just the opposite.
Custom have missed more what you call 9-pin breaks and 8-pin breaks
than
Grandpa's printing. 3 big marks open there. Just heard one of the crowd say that they're up 6, Grandpa's printing, and they have 3 marks open. So that means there's 10 pins in the difference. There's a 6. So that's 7 on that, so that puts him ahead by 1.
Well, Joe Ashline, after 6 completed frames, will go to 90, 30 over par.
Fabulous bowling. Just gotta love it.
Yeah, good shot there for Steve Webb. Steve had a lot of wood there, Bobby. That could have went or it could have stayed.
Yeah, sometimes the woods work against each other real bad. And
sometimes you little too much wood.
Yeah.
So Joe Ashline picked up 7 on his mark, 8 in the frame. Goes to 98, 28 over after 7. Steve Webb picks himself up a big spear there. And Stevie goes to 97 and open. Those two fellows are having a real close match here.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Webb's ball or his approach seems to be struggling just a bit here today, Doc. I mean, obviously at 25 over par, he's not hurting, or 35 over par. But just doesn't seem to be the same consistent delivery that Steve has. He's going from one side to the other.
I don't know if that wood Steve's got there is going to help or not, Bobby. If he gets that din on, he might just get that hit pin all by itself.
Well, it can't hurt on those shots.
Well,
it did hurt bad.
It hurt bad.
Did he hit it the pin on the outside?
He got it right on the outside. Big mark there for Joe Ashline of the Mass team. He'll go to 108 and open after eight frames. Steve Webb finishes up with a 9. Boy, they really got a close game going. Joe just needs 3 on it now to catch Steve Webb there after 8 frames.
And of course he's hoping for a heck of a lot more than 3, right?
Oh yes, definitely. Now we have Dave Richards here in lane 17, open on a mark. Barry Sauer in lane 18.
Big 9.
And I thought he should have had a strike there, Bobby. Beautiful hit.
Beautiful hit. Dave. My name's Bob McGlashan, and I'm with Ducky Vincent. We're at the Coca-Cola Classic here in the championship final between Custom Machine and Tool 1992 Classic Champs and Grand Prize Printing 1992 World Bowling Champions. And it's been a very exciting match so far. Lots of marks, lots of hard shots. We've had a double strike, we've had a triple strike. It's really not much more we can ask for.
You're right.
We got another string and a half to go.
That's right, Bob.
Maureen Beeler's looking after the scoreboard for us with able assistance from Larry Lovett. And of course, we have our favorite television crew down here from Channel 10, who have always been a big help to the sport of bowling here in Dartmouth. An 8-good break by Barry Sauer on a mark. Got lucky. Caught a break, Ducky.
That wood there had to have been in the back there. That one there might have rolled right over and taken the 7 pin there for Dave.
It was moving hard enough.
Yes, it was. He picks up a nice 10. Dave Richards goes 89, 9 over after 8. And we have Barry Sauer at 91 and open. Now in lane 18, Sean O'Flaherty, lane 17, Bob Kelly. They're having a very close game, Bob. There's only one pin difference here. Bob's open on a mark. So Bob just went one pin ahead now of Sean with that 2 on his mark.
Custom with those 2 marks that they were open there in the 7th and 8th. And of course, the world champs on the last 2 spirits had 2 in each one of them. And we were all ready to add up big time scores on them to project them into the lead. It just goes to show you that they don't have the lead anymore. Custom Machine and Tool are up by...
Still got a couple marks open. Each team still has a mark open. These matches are very close, Bob. This match here today, right here, there's only a couple pins between each bowler.
Well, Custom Machine and Tool are up 11, nearing the end of the second string. And they have a 16-pin lead from the first string. It's a 3-string total pinfall match. Boy, I tell you, Sean is having it tough, Ducky. Young Sean O'Flaherty just had an 8-pin break with Dibwood in around behind it, but great guides and missed a shot. Let's hope he can. What you need right now, Ducky, is a bowler, and you know this, you need a strike.
Yep.
You don't want any nine pin breaks with Deadwood. You want a strike.
Just to build up the confidence again. That's three bad misses for Sean in the string here, and you just can't afford that. So we still have a total 11 pins, Bob?
Right on, Ducky. 11 pins difference. Grandpa's printing from Massachusetts have one mark. That's when they're going good for you, Duck, when you punch out the guts and you get a shot like that. Graham's looking at a nice-looking spear chance here with the 2, 4, and 7. Deadwood in behind it, just has to catch a hold of the front pin and it should be gone.
That front pin is frozen, boy. If he gets that dead on, it could be... It could have been a problem or something like that. Shot, we just missed a Romindigo there.
Nice shot by Gary Carrington.
That was a nice spear there for Gary.
It's like getting two marks, Ducky. Graham Lassen missed a 7-pin break. Gary Carrington made a really hard shot.
Hot shot.
Graham got to 10, though, so he didn't drop any pins in the box.
The only difference right between Gary and Graham here will be what Gary gets on his mark. There's a big 8. So right now, that's what Gary is up on Graham, 8 pins. Ah, good spare there for Graham Lassen.
Nice pressure
Beautiful.
Shot.
Gary's got another good setup here.
Gary having a little fun up there. He's a very colorful bowler and a great bowler. This year at the World Bowling Championships in the singles, prior to the team tournament, Gary Carrington rolled a 728 to win the World Champion singles match. So a great character for the sport, a tremendous bowler. But you can't say enough about the shot Graham Lassen made. I know it's only 2 pins, but after missing a 7-pin break, Sean O'Flaherty missing an 8-pin break, and now you got those two lonely single pins standing up there, and you got to hit it right. And Graham made the shot.
He just did that.
Barry Sauer talking a little bit like he's from Massachusetts over there, Dougie. He'll be saying, got change for a quarter for a glass of water soon. No.
Boy, Peter's having a rough time here in this big roll-off here, Bobby. 108 is first string.
I would have bet money that he would have made that spear, Ducky. I would have bet money.
I would have too, especially with Peter in that 7-pin. He never misses that.
This is 2 7-pins. Well, the other 7-pin he needed to make wasn't quite a gimme because he had to hit it just going off the lane to get the spear chance. But isn't this something? One misses, the other misses.
Yeah, that's right.
But it must be very scary for Custom Machine and Tool right now, because I think that's 7 or 8 shots this string they've missed already.
That's right.
Maybe Grandpa's printing missed 3 or maybe 3 at the most that I consider really good spear chances. Now Peter's off to the left, and he's been off to the left the whole.
Yeah, he's not on his game at all right now.
Even when he seems to get to the front pin, Ducky, he seems to be going in light.
Yeah, that's right.
You know, the ball's not quite making it there to give it the power that it needs. Fabulous team, this is Grandpa's printing. A great friend of bowling here in Nova Scotia. Jackie Ray and I had a little talk 6 years ago now after we won the world title, Ducky, and just having a nice cold moose hit up in New Brunswick, and asked them if they'd be interested in coming for a promotion of bowling. It turned into this tournament, and they've been coming ever since. Every year they've been world champs, they've been here, and it's...
Bobby, did George give us a key to go to the scoreboard, or...?
No, not yet. I don't think we're going to go to it. We're going to just run down the teams at the end. Big strike for Joe Ashline on a spear.
He was open. takes Joe off to 118 with a plus a big strike open.
What a shot! What a shot!
For Steve Webb. Big shot for Steve Webb. That was a very important mark for him.
See a couple of great friends of bowling over there in Chester, Vincent and Peter McBean.
I see the boys over there, yeah.
Taking in all the shots, and the four of us throwing our hardest balls, never threw as hard as any one of these guys ever, Ducky. Double strike.
Yeah, these are the killers, those double strikes.
That's the second double strike in one string. So we've had a triple strike.
148 and open on a double. Throw a real one this time. Somebody said over there. Good try there for Steve Webb.
Stevie Webb's going long and picks up this 10. He'll have 135, Ducky, so really nothing to sneeze at.
That's
in his
right.
own right, but the double strike is sort of overshadowing his performance right now. That's a nice 9 for 134.
Good string there for Steve Webb, a big 134. He made a big improvement, Bobby, over his first string. At 105, now 134 for 239 for two.
He's right in there, Ducky. Ashline is a 138. With two balls to count. It's 27.
So he's 155 and open.
And there's seven down, so it's a 162 game anyway. Fabulous bowling.
164 for Joe Ashline. Joe had 116 this first game, so he's 280 for two.
Fabulous bowling. Nice round of applause from the crowd. They're all having a little fun with Joe now. No one wants to touch his bowling balls. He said, we're not good enough.
Dave Richardson, lane number 18, has a big strike, I believe, yes.
Could this be the year, Ducky, that the world champs finally win in Darby, Nova Scotia at the Coca-Cola Classic? This is the sixth year for this tournament.
I would not declare them winners yet, but I mean this one here, myself.
What a shot!
I've seen too many things happen to declare anybody a winner yet.
Fabulous, fabulous bowling, ladies and gentlemen. It's just so exciting to be sitting here. Not only the opportunity to bring in the match, but to sit here and watch it as bowlers. Ducky Vincent and I will tell you, this is just fantastic stuff.
I'll tell you, Bob, the marks are split pretty even here. The mass team of 18, and custom tool and machine of 17.
Of course,
a couple of the ones that the mass team had with those double strikes with big counts on them.
Yeah. Maureen Beeler over there is just going crazy, Doug. There's so many. What a shot.
Boy, there's two tough shots for a very solid, I'll tell you. Two great spears. So we had Dave Riches for the mass team with 118. The mass team, Bobby, is 282 after two bowlers completed their second string.
Nice little start, isn't it, to a 600 game?
Yes, sir.
Perry
picks up six, that'll give him 123. 121 his first one for 244.
We have a very tight match. Custom machine and tool, maybe we're up 10 or 11 pins going in the last two boxes. But of course, Joe Ashline, who threw a double strike in the ninth and 10th and was on a mark, took care of that. So I would say with custom 16 pins have now dwindled, and I would be a good guesstimate that the Americans are ahead. Now, Ducky, here's a tester for Sean O'Flaherty. He's missed three marks this string. Single pin,
that's
no way.
Right. Yeah, good shot for Sean, great shot.
That's what he needed. He needed that. Nothing fluky.
He
gotta
needed
hit
that
it.
In the worst kind of way, Bobby.
Yep.
That's nice to see. You hate to see somebody struggling like Peter Flynn is for the American team, and now Sean O'Flaherty. It's been seven long boxes before since he's thrown a mark.
Sean picks up a big seven. He's got another one there, Bobby. A little tough, but.
Well, he's trying to get a little body English into that shot, Doug.
I noticed that one, yes.
He says, I got to have one of these pins fall down. I don't want the seven pin break. Bobby's a right-handed. He throws the ball and that on that angle. He can send this two, three pin over.
And he did.
Wow.
Good shot.
Beautiful.
He hit that so clean, he even left the booby on the alley there.
Well, the single pin made or break him. If you would have missed that single, that would have been four marks in the string, and I'm sure Chris Pavarenzi would be warming up right now. But just a wonderful single pin shot, and then that super spear. I like the pretty shots, Ducky. I like the pretty shots.
So I think that should pretty well tie us up for the same amount of marks, Bobby. I think 18 in each side. Bob Kelly finished with 108 to give him 237 after two. Sean picks up a big six on his. And Sean is 126 in his first string and 119 in the second for a 245 total. They're having a very close match. They're just 8 pins difference. So after three completed bowlers in the second string, we have the main team at three, or the Massachusetts team at 390. And Custom Machine and Tool at 376. Just 14 pins.
Unofficially, I think Grandpa's printing are up 13 pins this string. And of course, Custom are up 16 pins from the first round.
Oh, what a battle that third string's gonna be.
Gonna be dead even, Ducky, going into these last two boxes, and of course. Gary just messed up. Way down the left. But Graham can bury this one. He may be key. Big 17 for Lassen.
Thrown away. 17 for Graham there, but he got a bit of a tricky wood here, Bobby.
Where do you think? Will he go the wood on the five pin deck or go for the three pins?
I think he's going to go for the three. But he had to miss that front wood.
Yeah, he couldn't touch it at all. Nice 10 for Graham. Gained a pin there. Gained four more on the spears.
So the overall total now, Bobby, for pins difference, but 14, 17, less 9. 8 pins for the MASH team. Grandpa's printing.
Wow, great shot by Graham Last, a beautiful 9-pin break, and Gary Carrington went down and punched out the middle, and he nearly threw the three over on the three.
Big spare there for Graham Lassen.
9 for Gary.
So that's going to cut the MASH team's lead down on 7 pins in this string.
Graham just goes about his business, doesn't he, Ducky?
He just gets
up there in the alley. He's all business. Right. Doesn't smile or carry on. Doesn't throw his body around too much. Just really tries to get it in there.
So we have the MASH team at 514 after four completed bowlers here in the second string of the Coca-Cola Classic. Very, very close match here. Now we have a tie game, Bob. Or maybe one pin, because Gary had a 9, I believe, in his last box. No, it is a tie game.
Tie game in the second string. Custom Machine and Tool are up 16 from the first match.
5-9.
To Custom Machine and Tools credit, Ducky, they've hung in there, and they had 164 thrown at them by the leadoff bowler. which is pretty phenomenal because, like,
that's
when
right.
you get the big score up front, it makes everybody think about it going right down the lineup. And they've hung in there tough.
I'll tell you, Bobby, this third string's going to be quite the match.
Still not, a tie match.
It's not too often you see a man like Peter Flynn rolling in the 87 in it for 9 frames. Of course, Dougie's not having that great a string this time either.
Just not getting that extra pin to fall.
That's right.
But it's a nice 9-pin break for him, and this can be like Sean O'Flaherty's shot a little bit. A little bit of a character builder, a little bit of a get the old momentum going back on your side. Hey, Nelson. Nice spear by Flynn. Blackler's looking at 2 different angles here. Nice spear.
That puts Custom up 8 pins in the second string, giving him a total of 24 overall so far. Peter Flynn picks up 6 on his. Oh, wait, no, I'm sorry, 9. And Dougie Blackler finished with 5 on his mark. So we have the Mass team, Grandpa's printing at 620. And we'll have the Custom Machine and Tool at 624, Bobby, 4 pins. So overall, we have a 20-pin lead for Custom Machine and Tool going in the last string.
Fabulous, very consistent bowling by Custom Machine and Tool, who had 2 624 games in a row. But as you look down the lineup, 134 for Webb, 123 for Soward, 119 for Sean O'Flaherty, 129 for Graham Lassen, and 119 for Doug Blackler. Very consistent bowling. The big story is how they held off Joe Ashline's tremendous 164, and that's really the what kept the World Champs Grand Prix bowling into this tournament.
But that's, as I said before, Bob, going into the last string, now we got a 20-pin lead for Custom over Grandpa's printing from the Boston area, and it's gonna be one heck of a match.
We're looking forward to the third and final string. We've completed 2, it's a 3-string total pinfall match for the Coca-Cola Classic Championship here at Webby's Bowlerdrome. My name is Bob McGlashan, and I'm with Ducky Vincent, and we'll be back very shortly to bring you the third string. Dave Richards is called by his teammates to just off to the right, both balls. Nice 10.
Oh, beautiful.
2 10. Nice 10. Soward at a 10. Dave Richards at a 10.
So right now we got 2 in this match, Bobby, and 22 overall. And there's only 5 boxes per team left.
And one mark open for Grandpa Lanes.
Right.
And if you remember in the first string, Gary Carrington was open on a spear in the 8th box and threw a double strike with 8 on that to finish off the match. So trust us, anything can happen yet. This game is still within reach for Grandpa Lanes to come back to Custom Machine and Tool. 3-string total pinfall. Two nice spear chances. Barry Soward with the 3 pins down there.
Well,
got to hit it.
Sooner have Dave Richards myself, but Barry's got a shot at one there.
Look at that, he hit it, Ducky.
Yeah, right around.
That is the most unpredictable shot in the lanes. Richards covers. Richards covers. Boy, this is good. I wonder what we do if we have a tie. We don't have a rule.
Got the hammer, Cookie Monster.
Two marks open. Sauer gets a 10.
If anything over two here now, we'll let Dave and them start working on their total.
Get him up!
Big six. That puts Grandpa's pretty up now. Four pins in the strings. 16 on the totals all the way down.
Wow. Dave Richards hit a 133. Barry Sauer to 136. It's getting close, Ducky.
So after the first two bowlers for Grandpa's printing, we have a total of 260. And for a custom machine and tool, 250.
Tonner!
Oh, oh. Just what the doctor ordered, I'm afraid.
We're saved. Port would have a fit.
Yeah, well, Port isn't here.
Oh, look, a bottle. It reminds me of Spain. That's a horrible country full of soldiers and priests and Jews.
Jews?
They run the country, of course, like everywhere else. Only in Spain they call themselves Católico. Católico.